for the flood of new reporting and late developments in the Trump-Russia investigation and the president's ongoing effort to brand a good deal of such reporting fake news. Now, this is happening with his son-in-law under real and growing scrutiny on Russia. It's happening with his former national security advisor and now his corporate lawyer facing questions or requests or demands for information pertaining to the Russia probe. It's happening with new reporting from real former intelligence officials and a real congressional source about Russian officials possibly having derogatory information on the man who would become president, possibly financial in nature. It's happening with a real inside source who speaks to the president, speaking to us about his frame of mind since returning from overseas. None of these is fake, yet the president would have the public believe otherwise. He tweeted over the weekend, quote, "It is my opinion that many of the leaks coming out of the White House are fabricated lies made up by the fake news media." He goes on, "Whenever you see the words sources say in the fake news media and they don't mention names, it is very possible that those sources don't exist, but are made up by fake news writers. Fake news is the enemy." Keeping them honest, John Miller or John Barron might have something to say about that. Those are the pseudonyms the president, then a businessman, reportedly used when phoning New York papers to plant flattering stories about himself. Fake names, fake sources, fake stories, fake news, real fake news. The so-called fake news he now objects to is coming from real people talking to CNN and many, many others. In any case, it's not that the president has exactly shied away from relying on unnamed sources when it suited him. August 6, 2012, quote, "An extremely credible source has called my office and told me that at Barack Obama's birth certificate is a fraud." Also that day, quote, "An extremely credible source has called my office and told me that Barack Obama applied to Occidental as a foreign student." Think about it. What's source for the goose is apparently not source for the gander. Today, pushing back on reports about Jared Kushner's attempt to set up a covert communications link with Moscow, the president cited a more flattering story on Fox News, which happened to be based, quote, on a source familiar with the matter. Here's what Sean Spicer said when asked about that contradiction.
That the president retweeted this morning an article about that back channel that was based on an anonymous source that said that there was an effort to set up a back channel, that it was the Russians who suggested that, and that it was to talk about Syria. Was the president not confirming that that effort, that there was an effort, and the facts that I just said?
I think what I just said speaks for itself.
But you said that first of all, that the article was based on anonymous sources.
Which it is.
But the Fox article that the president retweeted was also based on anonymous sources. Why are those sources, or the source rather, that they used more credible than the ones in the Washington Post article?
Again, I don't think there's two issues at hand. One is the statement that Jared's attorney has provided. Second is whether or not the dossier that is largely the basis of this was largely discredited in the first place. Most of the publications here refused to even publish it in the first place. So again, I'm not going to get into confirming stuff. There's an ongoing investigation.
He ignored the whole question about anonymous sources. Part of that effort that he was talking about centers on that dossier that Sean Spicer mentioned. And regardless of the sourcing, it's not accurate to say that dossier has been discredited. We're not reporting on the details of it because some of it is yet to be confirmed or disproven. To say, however, that it's been completely discredited in part or in whole is simply not true. In fact, as CNN reported in February, some parts of that dossier have actually been corroborated. For instance, the U.S. intelligence agencies have found that some of the meetings and communications contained in the dossier indeed took place on the dates and in the locations as described.